Alright guys, how you doing? Alright, I haven't did one of these in a long time. I'm gonna make it short and simple. So today I'm gonna be teaching you or showing you how I make the Sharingan from Naruto into the eye myself in real life. Now this may not be the best way of doing it, but this is just what works for me. There's another way you can do it on different softwares like After Effects. That might be a lot easier. But this is just what works for me because I'm broke and I'm on a budget. So first, you're going to want to have a shot of your eye. A good shot of, you know, make sure it's, you know, detailed of your, you know, your pupils. And then you're going to have a Sharingan. You can find one of these Sharingans on Google. You can look up any type of, you can look up anything, a PNG. I use a tripod, and so that way it's easier to edit in post-production. So first I'm gonna find a nice place to select my cut from. Okay, that looks good right there. When you do this, you're gonna wanna stare into the camera for maybe 5 to 10 seconds. Because if you look around or you move your head a lot or the camera's not stable, it's gonna be harder to edit in post-production. So now you're gonna drag your Sharingan onto the footage. All right, here comes the fun part. So let me make this a lot bigger. So right now it looks crazy, but so what I do is I go, and the software I'm using is Final Cut Pro, by the way, just to let you know. So what I do is I go to my effects. And the first thing I'm going to do is going to cut this Sharingan down to a circle. So we can get rid of the PNG stuff on the side. So I'm going to go to mask. And right where it says shape mask, I'm going to drop that on top of the Sharingan file. So now we're going to turn the curvature all the way up to 100%. We're going to raise. We're going to adjust our mask. All right. In the inner circle, we're going to pull that in. And then we're going to go to the feathering. And we're going to pull it. Sometimes it's better to do this manually. And you're just gonna mess with it, play around with it till it looks like a complete circle. All right, now that's done. You got your Sharingan down. So I'm gonna put that underneath the video file. So now I'm gonna go to my recording and I'm gonna find a shot where I can put the effect that. So I'm gonna say right here.
You. You. Mine is you.
Alright. So I'm gonna make a draw mask. I'm gonna go to mask again. I'm gonna go to draw mask. Drop that right on top of the file. I'm actually gonna cut the clip so that way the whole clip is in effect at the same time. Okay, so now we got a draw mask tool. Now in order to do the Sharingan, we're gonna have to basically cut a circle into the pupil of my eye so that way it reveals the Sharingan. What is that? Okay, we're going to reveal the Sharingan in my eye. So we're going to get very close. So we're going to have to zoom in a little bit. So what I like to do is I go to draw mask, go to B spine because that makes it more curvature. And you're just going to pretty much, let's try zooming out a little more. And you're just going to cut. Okay. So now we got this. I know what you're thinking. What the heck? And that's all right. So now what happened is it cut everything around the pupil out. So we're just gonna invert the mask. Right here where it says invert mask, we're gonna check that box. And now, as you can see, the underline of the Sharingan is revealed. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go to that layer where the Sharingan is revealed. And we're gonna go to this little transform box. I'll show you. It lets you adjust the shape or the size of the whatever object or picture you got. So we just gotta zoom out a little bit. And now we just gotta pretty much just line it up. And I think, and that's what we got. All right, this tutorial is done. No, I'm just kidding. Okay. All right, so obviously you got it now, but it doesn't look realistic. So what you're gonna have to do is go to this feathering, and that's gonna turn down how much the eye is shown, how much the mask is shown. And then you got opacity, which pretty much that is like the clarity of the image. So you wanna turn the feathering down just a little bit. And the lower you do it, the more real it will look. So you're going to keep turning it down, turn it down. Maybe turn back the feather up a little bit. As you see, we got the eye. Let's see. It's not perfect, but it's not bad either. Alright, so we got the eye. It looks semi-realistic. Could be better. Like I said, there's different programs that you can use to make it look even better than this. But I'm broke, so I don't know what to tell you. Okay, now, as you go through the footage, you're going to notice that it's not lining up as the camera is moving. That's when you have to do the tracking process. And you got to track two things. Well, for me, you have to manually track, which is a pain in the butt. You have to manually track the draw mask tool, which is what you made before. So we're going to turn this down. And to do that, you need to go to where it says transform and hit and click the position, rotation, scale, and control points. And that pretty much is making an animation on all these red points you see. So every time you go frame by frame and you adjust the mask to it, the mask will line up with the exact frame that you move it to. I'll show you how to do it in a minute. I don't know, this might not make sense to a lot of people who don't edit. So we're gonna zoom in again. So we're gonna go one frame at a time. So this is when I turn on music and I just go start jamming. So I go 1, 2, 3. So I notice that I move, so I adjust the frame. And this is gonna take a while, so I'm not gonna talk you guys to death. I'm just gonna do it and fast forward. Now we get the mash tracked, so we'll let you see what it looks like. So the Sharingan is not tracked yet, but if you turn on the mash, you'll see that it's tracked now. Now this is all manual, so it's not perfect. So sometimes I catch myself making mistakes, so I have to adjust it again. As you see, as it moves, as the eye or the frame moves, so does the mask. And it has to stay lined up. You think we're done, and we're not. The first mask on the top clip is done, and it's all tracked. We now have to track the actual Sharingan itself to keep it centered to a pupil. So the first thing I do is I hit the transform tool, go to this point right here, which adds a keyframe to the playhead. So you're gonna add a keyframe, click, and then it's the same thing. Now every time we go frame by frame, so this is what we got. So we're gonna zoom out. Turn this off for a second. And you pretty much do that for both eyes. You can adjust the glow. What I like to do is I like to come into to make it look a little fancy, I guess. You can find a glow, drop it onto the Sharingan. And we just turn it down a little bit. And as you can see, it still looks kind of, you can still see some imperfections. And that comes with, you may have to play around with some of the masking and feathering. Okay, we turn on feathering a little bit.
The only one dying is you.
Some other stuff I like to add. I add some sound effects that I just download from YouTube. And I just drop them underneath. So. Alright, here we go. So now, if you get that, now if you play it back,
the only one dying is you.
And now here's your finished product.
The only one dying is you.
Alright, that's the tutorial, and I think that's all we got. Not the best, I'm not giving these things, but it was asked for, so let me know what you guys think, and leave any suggestions down below. Alright, catch you later.